Sorry about that. While I was waiting for it to load, I beat the Death Knight, by the way. It was pretty easy. I just had to use a combination of gambits, attacks from lancers that defeat horses, and sacrificing Sylvain. So, where was I? Three more guys appeared down here.
Let me at him.
I will prevail. Stay focused.
Don't waste it.
Yes. You are making your way over to this treasure chest.
Who, me?
You are healing.
How sweet. That's my cue.
Turn is it, by the way? It's only turn 8.
Super grateful.
You go this way, you go this way, and you go this way.
This'll get him.
Nice. Nice. Jerk. Yeah, you might as well win. It's a good attitude. And she can't do anything. Intermediate seal. Nice. Is anyone else got a key? No? She's going down.
It is decided.
battle, a chance to grow.
Be awful losing to me.
Indeed.
If only.
How sweet.
Guy only a healer? That's all he can do?
Couldn't weather the storm, huh?
You're too late. The seal will be broken any minute now.
This should work.
Aha, only 45% chance of hitting. Try harder. This guy live, but not before inflicting serious damage.
Back?
It's no use. A seal is broken. You can't. A sword. What?
A hero's relic. Yeah, there's nothing in the middle, though. It's weird that it works. Took you long enough.
Is the intruder here? Oh, looks like you have this under control. You, round up any stragglers.
Will do.
All right. Go, Caspar. Sword of the Creator. Made Lucius a true power of Bela's hand, extending reached distant enemies, weapons durability is restored by 5 each time Baelith chooses to rest on her day off.
As all of you have committed a breach of faith, the Archbishop will now pass judgment.
Inciting a kingdom noble to rebel. Unlawful entry. The attempted assassination of the Archbishop. An attack on the Holy Mausoleum. It is unnecessary to go on, followers of the Western Church.
What? We have nothing to do with the Western Church.
You have already been identified. Please spare us your second-rate theater.
Dishonoring a holy ceremony is worthy of death for a member of the Church. You are well past the hope of redemption. If you have any grace remaining, you will willingly offer your life as atonement for this crime.
No! This isn't what we were told would happen! We've been deceived!
It's no use arguing. Whatever your excuse, the punishment stands. May your souls find peace as they return to the Goddess.
Wait! Please! The Goddess would never forgive you for our execution!
Monster! We know you've already slaughtered many of our fellow brethren like this.
This concludes the investigation. Please remove these poor lost souls from my sight.
That's that, I suppose. The assassination attempt, the attack on the Holy Mausoleum. It was all the Western Church's doing. That masked knight who led the attack somehow managed to disappear without a trace.
The Church of Saros clearly isn't as unified as it would hope to appear. It seems the Bishop of the Western Church was always opposed to the Church being ruled centrally from Garrig Mach. Perhaps they hoped to remove the Archbishop in order to completely strip the Central Church of its authority.
Oh, that's right. Geralt mentioned that you were raised without any exposure to the Church. In order to function more efficiently, the Church of Saros is split into several smaller entities. The Central Church is the largest, and leads the organization from Garrig Mach.
The Western Church extends from Castle Gaspar, where Lord Lenato rebelled, into the far west. They can be found just beyond the most renowned stronghold of the kingdom. The fortress city of Arion Road.
It seems the knights have been tasked with subduing the leaders of the Western Church. We may be given the opportunity to help them with their mission.
To think, our own professor was born in Fodlan, and yet knew nothing of the Church. I never imagined explaining something so basic to an instructor of mine. You're something of a special case, are you not?
Take those compliments.
It's strange that the Archbishop would ask someone like that to lead her students. There's clearly more to that decision than we know.
Lady Rhea is pretty scary sometimes. But to execute that whole group, just like that? It seems harsh, even for her.
If one of us does something bad, I wonder what she would do to us!
Professor, do you agree with the Archbishop's actions?
There you are, Professor. It seems Lady Rhea will have a word with you. Come with me.
Got it.
The Archbishop lives. Not that I had ever placed much faith in those swine from the Western Church.
I have news, both good and bad. The remains of Saros were not in a tomb. However, something else was. The Sword of the Creator.
Ah, the weapon wielded by that thief, the King of Liberation.
Thief? Huh. At any rate, it is now in the hands of the Academy's new professor. I doubt you will be surprised to hear that the Crest Stone had already been removed from the sword when it was found.
As expected. It would be foolish to keep both in the same location.
There's more. The professor was able to awaken the sword's true power. Even without the crest stone, the sword glowed red. The professor's crest is compatible. There is no mistaking it.
Absurd. Using a relic without its crest stone should be impossible. The King of Liberation's bloodline should not even...
They must be allowed to keep it, for now. I do not have enough information about the professor to act. As for your request, I assent. The Death Knight is at your command. Use him well.
Good. I believe I will enjoy this a great deal.
Right. Mysterious. Ooh.
I cannot thank you enough for defeating those invaders in the Holy Mausoleum. And especially for protecting the sword of the Creator.
Right.
That sword is one of the hero's relics, and the most precious artifact in the Church's possession. It is also a weapon of terrifying power. For now, I will entrust the sword to you. Please, use it wisely.
Lady Rhea, wait! Do you truly mean to give the sword of the Creator to this stranger? Surely it is not the sort of thing one hands over so readily, even to someone who has the ability to wield it. If someone like Nemesis were to appear again, all of Voltlin would be consumed by war. Nemesis, the King of Liberation. He is an ancient king of mankind who was defeated by Seros over 1,000 years ago. When Fodlan was attacked by wicked gods, it is said that the goddess gifted Nemesis with the sword of the Creator. Nemesis used that sword to defeat the wicked gods, saving all of Fodlan. Henceforth, he was dubbed the King of Liberation. However, his power began to corrupt him until he himself turned to the darkness. Saint Seros was forced to destroy him. Lady Rhea, I beg you to reconsider. Given a little more time, we could more accurately assess this stranger's abilities.
No. I have faith, Sereth. Faith that our friend here will not be corrupted by wickedness. Since the death of Nemesis, none have been able to wield the sword of the Creator. Now, after all those long years of being sealed away, it has returned and found a new master.
I understand. As you wish, Lady Rhea. There you have it, Professor. See that you do not betray the trust the Archbishop has seen fit to bestow upon you.
You got it.
The sword of the Creator? The sword of liberation? Each tale is more confusing than the last. And I really can't read that Rhea at all. That sword is clearly precious. So why is she so keen to gift the thing to you? I feel as though we have become entangled in a mystery. And there is one more thing that has been plaguing me. The sword of the Creator. It somehow feels distinct from other relics we have seen. Such as the one that... Oh goodness, what was her name?
Catherine?
Yes, her! The Sword of the Creator is different from her Thunderbrand in one key way. It bears a hole, where something should have been, but is no more. I despise not knowing what is going on. It frightens me. And yet, I place my trust in you. I must. Whatever comes to pass, please swear to cut a path that is your own.
Of course. All right. That's the goddess rite of rebirth.
Part 1. White clouds. Verdant rain moon. Tower of black winds. The ceaseless rains that satiate the verdant landscape of Fodlan are accompanied by fierce winds and mighty roars of thunder. This abundance of rain sparkling as it falls against beams of emerging sunlight, is a constant reminder to the people of Fodlan that nature is ever wild and unpredictable. For when the rain finally does take pause, the clouds part and give way to a glorious rainbow.
All right. Okay, so we got about 5 minutes left. Let's see what we can do in that time. New places to explore in the monastery. Receive 5,000 gold. Got some more cutscenes, it seems.
I have a new mission for you, Professor. I would like for you to take your students into Kingdom territory to eliminate some thieves.
They stole a hero's relic from House Gautier of the Holy Kingdom of Fargus, the Lands of Ruin. Their leader's name is Miklan. He is apparently a disowned son of House Gautier. I believe it had something to do with his lack of a crest. Such happenings are fairly common within the kingdom.
The crestless cannot unleash the goddess's power even if they possess a relic. Nonetheless, they are still capable of simply wielding those weapons.
The hero's relics are immensely powerful weapons. We must meet this threat with adequate force. Unfortunately, most of the Knights of Seros are away from the monastery, purging the apostates of the Western Church. So we are entrusting you with this mission. After all, you wield the sword of the Creator, which is more than capable of opposing any relic.
The sword of the Creator is a powerful weapon well beyond the other relics. You have nothing to fear. However, to ensure that no harm comes to the students, we will also send the monastery's most skilled individuals to aid you.
I must remind you that you are expected to conduct yourself in a manner befitting the wielder of that holy sword. Also, you should know that Professor Hanneman has been looking for you. That is all.
Professor, I heard about our mission for this month. A thief with a hero's relic is worrisome, but with you at our side, I'm certain we can handle him.
Thanks.
After all, you have the sword of the Creator. It was allegedly wielded by Nemesis, the King of Liberation. If the legends are true, you hold the power to stand against entire armies. A band of thieves should be nothing. Even the most elite Imperial forces or the Knights of Seros could not hope to defeat you.
I don't know about that.
Is that so? Even if those forces were to hurt someone precious to you? Can you say with full confidence that you would not turn your sword on them if that were to happen?
I guess not.
You know, your power does not lie solely in the sword of the Creator. You are stronger and more terrifying than you realize. Professor, when we leave the monastery, will you still think of yourself as my teacher? Never mind. I'm being thoughtless with my words. For now, let's just focus on the problem at hand.
Good of you to come, Professor. I've heard much about you lately. Specifically, that you are able to awaken the sword of the Creator's power. Thusly, it seems the true nature of your crest has been uncovered. I had, of course, seen your crest before. However, at first, I failed to recognize its true nature. Eventually, it dawned on me that what is visible is perhaps merely a small part of a greater whole. In other words, your crest is too significant to be detected when using normal instruments. After this discovery, I began researching crests that might fit that description, which allowed for a temporary hypothesis. However, I could not be certain. The crest my conclusions led me to was far too unusual. A crest thought to have disappeared from this world in the millennium since the fall of Nemesis, the King of Liberation. The Crest of Flames. That is what you possess. Your ability to wield the sword of the Creator has unequivocally proven my hypothesis. A legendary power, dormant since time immemorial, and now resurrected, there can be no doubt that this ancient power resides within you.
All right. Cool. All right, someone's birthday's coming up. Manuela, here's some flowers.
Bob, save. A ghost, perhaps? No, that is surely not the case. What is that look upon your face? I am no ghost, if that is what was on your mind.
No.
Who's there?
Professor, what are you doing here? Oh? Perhaps I was talking in my sleep. Oh, so you heard me then. Yes, it was a nightmare. I've had them since I was a child. Stupid, pointless dreams I can't control. It's terribly frustrating. No, they're just worthless dreams of the past. Talking about it won't change a thing. I had a feeling you'd say that. I suppose I could try, but only if you swear not to tell a soul. I appreciate it. I dream of my older brother, paralyzed, helpless. My older sister crying for help that never came. The youngest babbling words beyond meaning. I see my family dying slowly, waiting in the darkest depths for a glimmer of light. I once had 10 siblings, 8 older and 2 younger. Such a large family, and yet I became the heir to the throne. Do you know why?
They died?
Every last one of them was crippled by disease, or lost their mind, or died. I was the only one left who could inherit the throne. Things kept getting worse. The darkness kept getting darker. In the end, I was the only one who survived. The nightmares are a reminder to never forget, to never allow such terrible things to happen again. Even now, I'm the only one who can carry the weight of the Adrestian Empire. The future of the Empire, of everything, depends on me. I shared more than I intended to. I suppose there's something in the air tonight. I've never told anyone about my past before. Please, forget I said anything. Sleep well, my teacher.
You got it. Okay. All right, so 99% of people do the exploration, so that's probably what we're going to do. But that's it for now. Until next time, thank you very much for watching. If you like this video, please give me a like. Share, comment, subscribe. It always helps me out. When we come back, we'll do Rhea and Baelith, Edelgard and Petra, and Lindhart and Dorothea. And we'll also, I'll also see off screen which people I can level up with certifications. Till then, have a good day, and take care.